Welcome to Triviality's channel, where we are always learning while we talk about trivia. Today I will tell you about Luís Vaz de Camões, who was probably the greatest Portuguese poet of all time. And in this video, I will summarize his life so that you learn everything you need to know about him. Luís Vaz de Camões was born in Lisbon in 1524, the son of a low nobility family originally from Galicia. Luís was an only child, and according to the few records that exist, he moved from Lisbon to Coimbra while still very young due to a plague that devastated the city. He has been described as a medium-sized boy with red hair, a strong physical frame, and a little ill-tempered. His friends, however, describe him as a soldier of great courage, willingness to serve the crown, witty and cheerful even in difficult times. At the age of 12 or 13, his uncle, who was dean at Coimbra's university, took over his education, and he seems to have been an interested pupil, though he was known for being quite unruly. He knew Latin and Spanish besides Portuguese, and he read the works of the most important classic and modern authors, which made him a man of above average culture and education. In his 20s, Luís de Camões moved to Lisbon, where, being from a noble family, he settled in the court of Dom João III, where he began a bohemian life filled with love, dismay, quarrels, and street fights. Such was his life that shortly after, Luís decided to flee the city to spend a season in Ribatejo, until there was an opportunity to enlist and travel the world. Camões' first stop was Ceuta in Africa, the first city that had been conquered by the Portuguese at the start of their discovery age. He stayed in Ceuta for 2 years, and there he lost his right eye in a naval battle. After this, Luís returned to Lisbon, and once again, starting his bohemian life, found himself violently involved in a fight with an employee of the royal palace, wounding him by sword. Immediately condemned to prison, he is only released because he agrees to serve the Portuguese kingdom in India. This was the first time Camões was arrested, but certainly not the last. He left Portugal in 1553 in the same fleet of Fernão Álvares Cabral, son of Pedro Álvares Cabral, who first discovered Brazil. During his turbulent trip, Luís de Camões travels the same course of one of his heroes, Vasco da Gama. And by coincidence, this trip is not at all peaceful, having faced strong storms and facing 3 shipwrecks. As soon as he arrived in Goa in India in 1554, he spent almost a year sailing, he immediately set out on a war expedition against King Xembe, or King of Pepper. Shortly after this expedition, he was once again imprisoned, certainly due to accumulated debts or because he published some satires against the corruption lived in India's colonies. It was only in 1561, with the arrival of Dom Francisco Coutinho as viceroy, that he was sent loose again and actually put in charge of the assets of all the dead and absent of Macau. With this title, Camões now had the power and administration of all assets that were left behind by those who died in the region under Portuguese administration without leaving any descendants or a will. It is said that at this time in Macau, he began writing the Lusíadas in a cave that is still marked today. The reason why Camões decided to write his work in a cave, this is a mystery. It is during the return trip to Goa that Camões survives a terrible shipwreck close by the Mekong River, where he is able to go to shore holding only a copy of the Lusíadas above the water. The poet's bad luck seemed to have no end, and as soon as he arrived to Malacca, now Malaysia, he was immediately arrested, accused of improperly appropriating funds from the deceased during his last tenure in Macau. More than motivated to return to his homeland, he left for Lisbon in 1567, but he is deceived and betrayed by Pedro Barreto, being abandoned in the province of Sofala, now Mozambique. It was only by luck, and again because of his friendships with the nobility and the bourgeoisie, that he is saved by his friend Diogo Couto, who pays his debt, freeing him to resume his trip back to Portugal. Camões finally arrived in Cascais in Portugal in 1570. It is said that by this time he was close to finishing his final version of the Lusíadas, which he ended up reciting in court for King Dom Sebastião himself. It is said that the king, still young, was so impressed by the epic poem that he granted Camões an annual monetary compensation for his work. Unfortunately, the last years of his life were spent in a small, dirty room in Lisbon, in great poverty. He still lived long enough to learn of the disaster of Alcácer Quibir, or the Battle of the Three Kings, where both his king and the majority of the Portuguese nobility lost their lives against the Moors. He died of plague on June 10th, 1580. Thus is described the life and history, in broad strokes of course, of Luís Vaz de Camões, who is still considered by many the greatest writer and poet of the Portuguese language. I hope you liked this short video, and if so, do not forget to hit that like button and subscribe to my channel if you want more videos like this. Thanks for being here, and see you next time!